If Kevin were here, he would say, "Wow, what a great turnout." If he watched the beautiful tributes that were all over television last night about his life, he would say, "Look, Jill, I'm on every station and it's all positive." If he saw today's Sun papers, he would say, "Jill, I'm on the cover and above the fold." Kevin and I met on a blind date. I hated how he was dressed, but I knew that I could change that. I knew that Kevin was the one for me on the second date. I just did. Kevin wasn't known to be warm and fuzzy, but with me, he was, many times. In fact, we had only been dating for about a month, and Valentine's Day was approaching, and I love Valentine's Day. So I kind of hinted that I love Valentine's Day, so I wanted him to know. I really didn't expect much from the longtime bachelor, and he really surprised me. I walked into his townhouse, and he had red heart candies on the steps leading up to the first floor, and then there were two stuffed animals leading to the kitchen. One dozen pink and a dozen red roses are on the table, and a box of chocolates, and I'm not even done. He had balloons too. I knew then he really liked me. Kevin never forgot a birthday. He never forgot an anniversary or any other holiday requiring cards or flowers for me. He was great at that. He wasn't great at speaking his feelings, but he would always do it, whether he wrote it down in a letter to me or gave me the perfect card. Even when Kevin got really busy. One anniversary not long ago, I received a beautiful delivery of roses, and I think it was our anniversary about 3 years ago. I was so excited and I couldn't believe it because he's so busy, and I opened the card and I was reading it and it says, "Happy anniversary, all my love, Sam Moxley." He was busy, but the flowers arrived. Kevin took care of everything for me. As busy as he was, he never let me worry or stress about anything. He paid the bills. He filled out kids' forms. He helped me clean. He did laundry. He told me when my car needs to go in. You know, they say give a busy person something to do and it'll get done. Well, it was true. He just took complete care of me. So this last year was rough. We rarely saw each other. He was a little moody. He barely slept. He wasn't eating well. He could never just sit and relax and take a breath. His mind was just always going. But he was in this to win it. He was driven and he loved what he was doing. He was looking tired to me, I thought. And just last week, I said to him, "Kevin, this campaign is killing you." He said to me, "We're at the last stretch. This is it. Not much longer. We have about 50 days left." So, we both have big birthdays this year, like big birthdays. And we were talking about what we were going to do, and we decided to postpone our celebrations until after the election. Everything was after the election. So my advice is to everybody, don't postpone any celebration, any event to celebrate. Just do it, because we didn't get to do that. We were supposed to take a great trip. I always got so angry when someone would say how all politicians are corrupt, or politicians are liars, or don't trust a politician. Because that was not Kevin. Kevin was very ethical, very moral. He was very honest. He never lied, and he hated a liar. He loved what he did. He did it. It was his passion. And he did it right. 100% he put into it. So today, this should not be happening. I have to say goodbye today to my rock, my best friend, my confidant, my partner, and my love of 19 years, the father of my two beautiful boys who are, we're gonna be good, we're gonna be okay. And if I didn't say it enough, I am so proud of you, Kevin. I was always so proud to be able to say, my husband is Kevin Kamenetz. And I truly felt so happy and so proud to be your wife.